Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting propaganda cast with me, your host, Imperial Dane, featuring today a one versus one on daytime Samoa. Yes, indeed, it's still Samoa, and yes, we've had a lot of matches on Samoa recently, but again, I'd rather have to go for what, you know, is actually fun to watch rather than what is different to watch in some cases. In terms of maps, that is. So, back to Samoa indeed, but this time in the day, so less gloomy and doomy. We shall be having a rather high-level fight. We shall be watching WMD, Dev M, Damn Evil, Vicious Mouse, fighting for the Americans, fighting for the 2nd Infantry Division, going up against RC Lollipop, fighting for the Wehrmacht, fighting for the Panzerlehr. So this should prove to be quite the fight between the two forces. With the two engineers start going up here, rifle on the way for Dev M. Wehrmacht quarters also up, units on the way there, and pioneers apparently sent a bit too far. Nonetheless, securing also there. In fact, so far, rather reasonably mirrored, of course, except Lollipop likes to start out with the MG followed up by a bike, whereas Dev M, you know, goes for rifleman. Of course, he could go for a Jeep second if he so desires. And he, in fact, does. Interesting. It's already something there. A bit intriguing. And also note here, he's not continuing towards. In fact, he's routing the pioneers down here. Of course, since the MG will, of course, be rushed forwards rather swiftly, the pioneers will have to, of course, secure anything behind that. And this is something Lollipop likes to do on this map. He likes to rush in his MG42 and take up an advantage position, a advantageous position. In this case, he's actually taking up position in the church. Usually, though, he likes to go in and try to sort of go for a very early pin. But not on Dev M's watch. He probably knows of this, of course. Now, the bike, though, is rushing in. He might be trying sort of to try and push out the rifle so they actually get out of heavy coming, thus can't get suppressed. Jeep moves in, bike under heavy fire, intense fire in fact, from Dev M's men, already damaged engine. Pioneers though are nearby to provide repairs. Engineers moving in. Rifle, and there we go, they are suppressed. I mean, heavy cover does provide in fact quite a bit of suppression resistance, but ultimately it is resistance and not immunity. And this Jeep is actually heavily damaged. And needs to get out, there we go, the bike's actually pushing in, going for Dev M's Jeep. Dev M might already here, has gotten a bit too bloody greedy. He tried to chew off more of the German bread, and there we go. He choked on it and lost the Jeep. And this is definitely not turning out to be a good engagement for Dev M. He's barely caused any casualties, if any. And he's already lost a Jeep and 3 riflemen. A horrible initial engagement for Dev M right there, I would say. Heavy losses haven't been incurred and without really doing any much damage or even securing a lot of territory. Oh dear. 2nd MG42 up for Lollipop to provide heavier control. Bike pushing in, opening up on the rifle there. The rifle trying their best. And of course the MG42 pushing up, although it looks like it's lost one gunner. In fact, rather low on health. That could be to the advantage of Dev M if he somehow manages to, well, pull it off. Bike again getting repair, one kill, one vehicular kill. Quite the bike. And the other MG42 coming in. This case of southern incursions by Dev M. 1st Infantry Squad out for Lollipop. The Fuchs Grenadiers march out to the beats of the Wehrmacht. Certainly not a hilarious start right there for Dev M. Looks like he's moving most of his engineers in a southern pattern, although this engineer is definitely not in a good condition. I have no idea why Dev M is sending in ahead. In fact, one burst from that MG42 and yeah, he's dead. And the other one's still covering here. Of course, they can there we go, of course. Moving up through here. Of course, trying to set up perhaps a larger flank, and that could actually work out. Coverage on the flank by with a mine and some barbed wire, but of course, they could just try and hook up even further behind. Initial assault does not work out for Dev M. And the Wehrmacht quickly moves in to intercept. Where shall the MG42 move about? Taking up position in the house or going for an even deeper pin on the choke point of Dev M. Bit of barbed wire going down, engineers moving in. Trying to ambush the pioneers. Will they succeed? Lightly. Not fully, because now they're on the wrong side of the cover.
Grenades have arrived.
Ooh. And there we go, MG42 crew down. He tried to retreat it, but sadly he found himself mixing up with the rifle. This opens up for the full assault by DevM against Lollipop. Troops of the Panzer, they are getting a bit suppressed, surrounded. In fact, we are seeing additional squads of Volkskrieg moving in to try and contain this bike below half health. Volkskrieg getting behind cover. Could we be seeing grenades from DevM to be lopped against them? No, they retreat further. Mines attempted on the steps of the church, but no more. MG42 moves in, rifle moving up in the flank. Looks like we might be seeing a stand right here by Lollipop setting up in the cemetery. Either they win here or they get buried here. Or there, whatever. Quickly connecting the cutoff point. Rifleman not moving in, interesting enough. Although now, of course, the MG42 from the cemetery is doing their best to suppress them. Rifleman here are simply outgunned by the Volksgrenadiers. And of course, the question is, how will this stalemate be broken? Bikes being sent in, taking a bit of damage from the rifleman. Mines going down there. Lovely mining from Lollipop, at least when he attempts to it and somewhat succeeds. Raven here, I'm not in a good condition, and a mine going down there. Mines everywhere. Oh, bike out of control. He did not make it out of there. Raven down to 5 men. The Volkskrieg keep up the pressure, although at the same time, Lollipop is leaving his flank open in case DevM pushes in here, but he does not. It certainly also helped with the fact that but why here, meaning of course he has to go through there, get some engineers to cut, and of course he's already lost some. And now DevM apparently tries to break the stalemate for another method. He's getting the weapon support center, he's getting a sniper, slightly slower form of assault. Of course, could work. In the meanwhile, Lollipop begins wiring off the main roads into town and any sort of other bits. That could definitely be to his advantage, of course, instead of course mean he can control the movements of DevM much better. Of course, it'll make sure any sort of assault going on against him will be considerably slower. So all of a sudden, this has turned into Festung Semois, which was something the Führer did when he had rather didn't want anyone to sort of move any point further back to, say, a town. He designated a fortress to be held to the last man. And usually they weren't prepared for it at all. And in several cases, they were actually just basically sort of allowed to retreat at a certain stage when it was quite clear they wouldn't be able to do anything sensible either anyways. But there were many times where it also didn't happen and they fought to the last. And also in many cases where basically the fortress towns were bypassed. But there we go, trying to cut the wire, but of course the MG42 ensures that does not happen. And of course that means if he actually wants to get through, he has to go through the cemetery. Oh, never mind, there's also the point here, and mine spotted. And of course, we do know that DevM has grenades. He could try and, of course, set it off with a grenade, thus saving the manpower, and of course, allowing him to quickly advance. Though it is a slightly more expensive way of clearing up mines, but not as quite as expensive as using manpower for it. MD42 quickly pulling back. Veteran team, one up. So already the Kampfkraft Center, already at Krieg Barracks. And a half tank is out. The Panzerlehr pulling in its Sonderkraftfahrzeugswagen 51, die mittlere Schützenpanzerwagen, and I suspect DevM is not really prepared for this. Of course, his sniper's not really fired a shot either, partly because he's right now, of course, if he has to retreat, he's going to retreat right past the half track, which could cut him down with his machine guns. And now the half track begins to ruin all the nice work done here with the barbed wire. That was perhaps less sterling work by Lollipop. But there you go. Volkskrieg moving up to support it. MG. Looks like we might be seeing some movement towards here to the other half of DevM's territory. Although currently, in fact, he's actually holding most of the territory. And he's following up with a mortar. He's still yet to use his sniper. Mine's going down there by the church. Still no sniper shot from DevM. I wonder what he is hoping to achieve with the sniper. He's clearly got some sort of plan with it, but I wonder what. And more barbed wire going down to again limit the movement of his opponent. And there we go, Raven sniper opening up, getting one pioneer. Does Lollipop save him? Yes, indeed, retreating swiftly. And again, more barbed wire. Quite incredible to see all this barbed wire. And now the motor's going to move up again, a sort of slower and more methodical advance now from the Americans. Of course, Christian becomes, they want to be actually a bit more speedy in their assault. And certainly, of course, that might also be more crap because, again, all the barbed wires, of course, making it a much harder thing for DMM to advance. Of course, he could also have gone in this case with all the barbed wire, of course, for the motor pool much swifter and basically rush in with Mama Castle a half track. That could also work. But no, instead, we are seeing snipers and mortars. Half track pulling away, Volkskrantz nearby to support, of course. Quite the little strike force, and Grenadiers out. Mines being swept. Nicely done there, of course, by DevM. And Grenadier finding himself with a bullet between his eyes. The rest, though, keep pushing on. Getting a few rifles in the process, but the sniper gets another Grenadier. A bit unfortunate there. Half track charges in. Will we be seeing sticky bombs? Yes, indeed, sticky bombs for DevM. Right on the half track, and kaboom, damage. Engine almost down to half health, of course. Also, reason to use Pioneers, that way you can actually quickly pop them out and repair the half track. Rifles are getting suppressed. Mortar awfully close to getting the MG, and more wire. Lots and lots and lots of wire. And also just generally good usage of said wire, although in this case he might be wiring himself out. Jürgen, don't you think we should be standing on the other side? Ah, shut up, Heinz, you're always worrying too much. And of course they will soon realize there's no way of getting back. And as of course they want to retreat through here, which is a slightly more risky venture. So of course there's of course a reason he might be doing it like this, of course, is also to deny the heavy cover, so of course they can't just take up positions there as well. But advancing up, some bastard sniped. By the looks of it, the machine gunner went down. And a bit sad that his friends are leaving him. Mine goes off right from advancing, and of course the half tech is still there already with one kill and five barbed wire kills, although they don't really count, Helmut. And the Raven here are just getting absolutely pummeled with machine gun fire. The half track and the MG just keep firing. Mortar even a bit further up. Gets one MG gunner, that's nice. Oh, MG crew down! Lollipop is without heavy machine guns now. And the Volkskrantz trying to sneak through here. Why they didn't go through there is a bit beyond me, but they got some press themselves. But ouch! That's definitely going to be hurting Lollipop and the Panzer Lehr that they have without heavy machine guns. At the same time, also, no, he's actually got three Pioneer squads and some infantry for his infantry. And he's taking up for the battle phase. He's going for the Panzer Command. Definitely tricky stuff right there. All sneaky. Mortar keeps firing in the hopes of catching a few Krauts. Oh, awfully close to hitting the half track. All the Pioneers nearby for that matter. Does a bit there. Three kills so far. That is the entire MG crew, of course, killed, but nothing else. DevM rather pushed back. He's having a bit more trouble, you know, actually applying the pressure. Perhaps some branding automatics might have helped him, or an armored car or something. Panzer Command going up. Fresh barbed wire there. Engineers moving about. Half track on the move. On the prowl. For Yankees. And there we go. Not entirely sure what DevM is hoping to achieve there. And pushed out from the center almost. Pioneer sniped. Attention. And Pioneer run off. Advances. Perhaps DevM might also want to consider a medic Germany station. Panzer Command almost halfway done. Engineers on the run again. Holding up here quite nicely, although of course we are seeing a bit of harassment going on by DevM, so of course try and limit the amount of resources Lollipop can secure. And there we go, on the run for MP40 equipped Volkskrantz. In fact, he's equipped all of his Volkskrantz with MP40s and more assault-borne army for Lollipop. And there we go, another sticky bomb for Lollipop's half-track. Immobilized, in fact, this could prove to be advantageous if Dev M can get off the situation. Oh, grenade on the mortar crew leaving. And there we go, already repairing and already no engine damage. Oh dear, oh dear. Sadly, Dev M was not quite swift enough to fully capitalize. We are seeing a Greyhound out though. This could be what is needed. Grenadier down quickly. Dropped by 50 caliber fire. Raked and dead. But the half-track is allowed to escape. At the same time, we are seeing the Ottoman flak panzer and a pack up. We'll use the pack on the way. Trier Center going up for Dev M. Sniper continues killing, getting veterans who won. I mean, he's not really gotten a lot of usage out of that sniper so far. Which is definitely not to the advantage of, Dev M, considering, I mean, how much he costs. I mean, he's not even halfway through to actually making sure he's worth the resources. Ow! Further unfortunate luck for Dev M and the 2nd Infantry Division in the fight against the Panzerlehr. And there we go, the Ostern Flak Panzer rolls out. More movement from the Yankees. Looks like Lollipops, there we go, setting up, firing away. The pack perhaps would just clear out the cover, that could be, or just by accident. Dev M moving the rifleman straight into MP40 range, and out in the open. That was definitely not a clever move by Dev M. And there we go, of course, setting himself up a bit for a mortar barrage. Still not a lot of kills there. Greyhound stabbing in advance with the Fulks Grenadiers. 37mm gun and the 50 caliber doing their best. Sniper joins in for a bit of fun. And there we go, the Ostwind Surprise blasting through the cemetery, knocking down cemetery walls. So far, not really killing anything. And in fact, pulling out. But of course, Dev M is not quite prepared for that. He's got sticky bombs, but trying to get too close for that could easily net him some rather squished out riflemen. And veterancy already up for one foot for the armor. That is good. That is very good. Wunderbar even. Fulskers, though, continue to get blasted by the armor car. Half check moves up to reinforce. Not a bad idea. Again, good usage of the half check with 5 kills, by the way. Lovely. The munition objective is ours. Ooh. Was close, very close. We are seeing the Ostman moving closer. I mean, if the sniper reveals himself now, he could find himself with a 37mm anti-aircraft round through his face, which generally is considered bad for your health, if in fact not fatal. And there we go, more fighting, and again, Dev M is rather lacking. There we go, propaganda war, forcing away all the rifle and anti-tank, and though it's moving up, nice use of terror right there. And of course, question is, what sort of doctrine has Dev M going for? Volksgeist charging in, and this of course is quickly going to set up. We haven't seen Volksgeist taking up position in the church to fire down. The Greyhound is still there, but the gunner dead. And now the Ostman rolls in. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Oh, the Ostman by accident sets off the mine laid down by Dev M, destroying the engine and pretty much leaving his own armored car wrecked. Oh, the unfortunateness right there. Definitely what you don't want to happen. Fulskers are continuing to get sniped. 11 kills. He's getting closer to redeeming himself, but he needs a lot more. A lot more before that really succeeds. At the same time, we are seeing a few engineers sort of moving up out here. That's good. Panzer IV on the way to support the Panzerlehr. Definitely also nice. And there we go, Fulskers called out in the open by Rifleman, who shall win this engagement with the grenades. Looks like the Fulskers are quickly pulling back. Ostman pulling up. And Veteran T2 for the sniper, definitely looking a bit up there, bit up. Grenadiers, Fulks Grenadiers, the half-tack for some reason pulling back, not ensuring the troops can be reinforced at the front line. And howards are going up, so we're clearly seeing infantry doctrine up for Dev M. And repair bunker up for Lollipop. At the same time, no medic bunker, none of that for him. Then we go to the Panzerkampfwagen 4. Out. And the roar of the howitzer, where should it be trying to fire? Probably around here, but too late. Instead, we see the restaurant retreating while the armor just pulls up towards the repair bunker. At the same time, pushing up here on the western flank with most of his riflemen forces. Mines going down on the road. Lovely.
We're losing a sector.
Volkswagen is holding off until the Panzer IV arrives. And there we go. Also, veterancy 2 already. I mean, it's actually a bit rare you see veterancy being accrued that fast for panzers, I think. But returning for Dev-M now with howitzer artillery. Still, Dev-M is in one pickle of a problem. He's actually lacking anti-tank assets, and he's not really working towards it. In fact, don't you think he needs a howitzer at the moment? Perhaps he should have gone for a tank depot instead, gotten some upgun shams and some tank destroyers. Ooh, Usman hits a mine right there. Nicely done. I.e. mining, not the whole money into it. Grenade goes off and doesn't really do much. German infantry continues into the cemetery, unimpeded by the grenade. Sniper on the run, mortar crew on the run, rifleman largely ignored, feeling a bit hurt there. And not really respected by the Germans in that essence. But veterancy one, that's helpful. Mine goes off here, doing and wounding a few Germans up north. Anti-tank gun trying to escape, but the gunners might finish it off. Oh, mine goes off, killing two and leaving the rest pinned. Quite the stroke of luck right there, just as the Panzer IV rolls in. Veterancy 2 machine gunner on top of the anti-tank and has to be careful. One hit and that could be the end of the... There we go, in fact. Finished off by the Panzer IV. Quickly recruiting it. These riflemen need to get out of there, Dev-M. You are playing it a bit risky there. Of course, question, if he can get off a Sticky Bomb, he can actually do some good against that Panzer IV. But of course, at the same time, he is facing off against a Panzer IV with high explosive rounds and a machine gun on top. More mines going down there. Good, good. Pioneer's getting hunted down and sniped. Bit quiet. Points being secure. The Panzer IV slowly rolls back. Dev-M advances once more up the west part of the map. Browning automatics on the way for his riflemen. And more propaganda war, sending two rifle squads away. And swift counterattack by the Panzer IV. Anti-tank on the move! Oh no! Definitely not good. On the other hand, the Panzer IV could be moving a bit too close. There we go, nice hit. Will there be armor-piercing rounds? I think so, but not enough. At the same time, Germans are pushing up through the center. Only a mortar to stop them. Not quite helpful, but we are hearing howitzer rounds. Might be able to get the Pioneers. Damaged engine, half health, but the anti-tank gun is completely surrounded. And the howitzer's flying way too high. And the anti-tank gun is left watching there. Interesting, interesting. And of course, wrecking the anti-tank gun so the Americans can't reuse it, of course, forcing Dev-M to spend more resources on such measures. Definitely a not good day for the 2nd Infantry. And there we go, the Panzer IV charges forward, catching Yankees out in the open, blasting them apart. Not really a good engagement either there. Again, Dev-M is sorely lacking on armor of his own. He's in fact much too immobile, considering, I mean, the sort of mobility that Lollipop possesses. Well, I was trying to say before, so rudely interrupted by Faps, the lack of mobility is hurting Dev-M because it's actually allowing Lollipop to choose sort of the field of battle, usually with quite the advantage. Particularly since the anti-tank guns are more reactive weapons, making it a bit more difficult. And of course, you can set them up in a proper position. But so far, the anti-tank guns are sort of more laid-back positioning with not enough support to protect their flanks. More artillery. Fulcrum's right in the center, taking a few hits. Half track standing about doing nothing. Ooh, we could lose the pioneers.
Enemy unit down.
Ooh. And the pioneers were gone. Going for the grenadiers here, killing one man, veteran T2 for the German infantry. Heavy the grenadiers of the panzer there, they'll quickly pull away. Rangers could be on the way, but most likely not. And more on the way for the Panzer Command and the Panzer Lehr. Lehr standing basically, you know, for training, which the Lehr division was basically composed of training personnel, but also, you know, demonstration personnel. I mean, these were the best men, and this was, you know, sort of, well, demonstration division, in a sense. I mean, it was formed on the order of Guderian, from what I know, to sort of provide them with a much quicker, as quickly assembled elite division, which was probably in fact one of the most lavishly equipped divisions, better than the SS could even muster, although didn't quite have the same manpower allotment, which was rather where the Waffen SS shine. They could actually still continue having three battalions of infantry for every infantry regiment. Regular army divisions couldn't. Ostwin moving in towards the north again. The lack of mobility is hurting. He's of course forced to sort of spread out his anti-tank guns, but of course also leaves gaps which Lollipop could take advantage of, is in fact doing right here. Another minor engagement right here. Engineers versus Volksgrenadiers moving in. The MP40s blazing, threatening to gut the Yankees, but a sniper provides a bit of cover there. 17 kills. He's definitely getting closer to actually having paid off his cost. Rather moving in and catching the Volksmen out in the open. Another down. And veteran is free for his armor already. That's definitely nice. Of course, increases the accuracy of the Ostwind. But of course, in the case of the Panzer IV, protects quite nicely against E-bombs. Advanced by Grenadiers. Ooh, mine hits. Suppressed. Volksgrenadier assault stopped. But Knights Cross are moving in. So Ritter Kreuz of the Panzer Lehr. And the Panzer IV advances, making this a rather risky proposition for the Waffen, causing a full retreat. Anti-tank gun trying to get out. And a unit is down somewhere. Oh, heavy losses. Volksgrenadier is going down. Grenadier suffering. Nice artillery hit, but he could lose the anti-tank gun at the same time to the Ritterkreuzträger. Raven moving in from the north, trying to stop this assault and contain it. Suppressive fire could stop the Knights Cross, and that's usually the best bet for Raven initially. And there we go. But only suppressed. In fact, the Knights assault rifles are still tearing through the Raven, and oh dear, he could in fact lose the squad nonetheless. And there we go, despite retreating, he lost the unit. Snap, they're moving up to try and help. Panzer IV trying to knock out the anti-tank gun, though having quite a hard time actually hitting anything. Half-track still standing about doing nothing. Ostwind getting repaired in the north, heavily damaged in fact. Knight's Cross could get lost, and there we go, recruiting the anti-tank gun, Panzer IV. The target, could we see army piercing rounds, and of course the Panzer IV has the advantage over the Ostwind that it actually has more health, amongst other things. Plus of course it's also more effective against armor while still being Germans pretty good against infantry. And for some reason he fired with a sniper against the Panzer IV, not really the most effective thing. Additional Panzer IVs rolling out. Infantry forming up, and where could we find that? Howitzer? Ooh, getting a few Volksgrenadiers again. A nice artillery usage. Veterans, you won. Another squad rifle on the way. Perhaps we'll play something lost. Not a bad idea, but he's certainly feeling a bit more contained. Panzer 14, a nasty few hits there. More armor rolling up. Could be setting up for an assault down here. That could work out quite nicely. Not a bad idea at all for Lollipop. Could in fact catch all of DMM's forces right here in the town in a nasty little pincer maneuver. Troops moving down south. Mortar firing away. Probably trying to disrupt any sort of assault movements. I mean, this is pretty much a preparation zone for any assault on the town. Of course, in that case, mortaring it is going to be a pretty good bet. But in this case, he's not lining up there. He's leaving most of his forces either up here, or he's apparently lining up for something down south. Knights Cross, Frostcast moving in. Who could be setting up for an assault there. That could work. Both anti-tank guns there. Knights Cross getting into the half deck. He's definitely lining up for some sort of assault. At the same time, the Panzer IV managed to force away the rifle in the north. Half check on the move. Where shall it go? What should its target be? Filter is getting sniped in the main while. 19 kills. Mines here and there. That's good. But perhaps something to protect the victory point as well. And the half track's on a mission. He's not sending in there. He could he be sending in for some sort of base rush? That would definitely be interesting and a bit unorthodox, considering he's only got Fulskins and the Knights Cross squad in it. What could he be hoping to achieve? I wonder. Anti-tank gun sneaking up. Rifle on the run, having suffered too gravely. And the husband taking a bit of damage. Lovely. Rifle getting spotting the half tank, but the half tank continues. Unstoppable. And of course, in the game, it has access to a flamethrower upgrade, which is rarely used. And of course, the Stukas Fools upgrade, which sees more usage, but not necessarily always. And of course, in the actual war, there were quite a few variants. So, even one that sort of used the same gun as the one by the early Panzer IV, the Panzer IV Infantry Support Tank, for example. But there we go, going to the base. This is a base rush, but again, perhaps not the sort of usual thing. And is he going after the howitzer with them? That's interesting. Veteran T2's unit suffering up a bit here. Grenadiers are gravely wounded, and he's panzerfausting the howitzer. That's definitely a more expensive way of dealing with this. Sticky bombs. He could try with some suppressive fire from the rifle, but he needs more forces in immediately to try and contain this, unless of course he fancies losing his howitzer. And there we go, more Panzerfaust. Panzerfaust in fact almost gone. Fulskis are getting suppressed. Sniper moves in, he has to hurry. Damaged engine on the half track. And there we go, one more Panzerfaust. Oh, doesn't do anything. Fun. Sniper just needs to keep killing. Puts it down, and there we go. The howitzer is gone due to a pretty irregular base assault to knock out the howitzer. Definitely not what you see. Rather expensive, costing most of his munitions, yeah, in fact, to do it like that. But definitely a nice method of improvising a measure like that. Panzer IV moves in, but it's a mine. But there's not a lot to stop him. The anti-tank gun, by the way, is way too far back to actually do a lot. And thus actually misses out on a huge opportunity. At the same time, a King Tiger could find itself called in. Three Panzer IVs and an Ostwind, all veterans are free. But this was definitely a huge blow to Devem and the 2nd Infantry Division. Probably not what you expect. I mean, he could reasonably well hold off a larger infantry force at the same time, particularly due to the half track. And the Panzerfaust slowly but surely knocked out the house. Again, rather different method of doing it, but definitely not a bad one, but a costly one in munitions. Ooh, heavy anti-tank gun fire there. There we go. Devem pushing forward. He's still lacking armor. I really think he should consider getting a tank depot up. More Knights Cross coming out. In fact, now Devem is in fact having a rather large infantry force, lots of assault weapons, assault rifles and submachine guns, and well, one Grenadier squad without any of that. Although of course he could, I suppose, get it some LMGs. Devem holding on to most of the victory points, holding on to the town centre, but not much else. And again, that howitzer was quite the blow. 30 caliber out for Devem. That's novel. Definitely novel. More to the veterans who won. Slightly slow advance there. Knights Cross getting mortared a bit, complaining about it. Grow up, you babies. And there you go, grenade over the hedge and killing absolutely nothing. Panzer IV rolls in. Mine goes off, but does nothing, I think, to the Panzer IV. That was rather rubbish. Or perhaps that was actually a mortar round a bit hard, I think. So it looks like both players are sort of biding their time, making ready for whatever sort of assault going on there. Knights crossbowing in from north, but getting fired upon by the church. 30 caliber sent up. Again, going for the cutoff point again. No real protection there. He's protecting the victory point with a small force. But of course, question is, will he actually be able to hold it? And why didn't he get a medic station earlier? That might have helped him a bit in the longer run. Oh, nice hit right there. Down to two men. Sniper continues sniping. Gets a grenadier. Lots of mines there, and there we go. Propaganda wall pushing them away. Mines not quite there to stop them. Anti-tank and getting rushed. Sniper moving in. No counter sniper, by the way, from Lollipop, but he probably feels quite confident, not bothering. One grenadier down. What's been rolling in? Knights crossing down the anti-tank gun. Panzer IV suffering. Getting hammered. In fact, very low on health. And there we go. The anti-tank crew is dead. The Knights Cross have found the next tank. In fact, that's a fresh sniper. He's actually gotten two snipers out now. I definitely think that's a wrong move by DevM. Again, he needs something to deal with the armor a lot more conclusively. And trouble is, the anti-tank guns aren't quite cutting it. Need something that can react a bit faster. And otherwise, I mean, constantly Lollipop will have the advantage. Instead, he will have the initiative because, again, he can just shift armor. He can just move it about much more easily in a much better manner that DevM can actually react. And that's a huge problem for the Americans. Rather than at the same time getting blasted again, he just can't quite get close enough to that Ostwind. And he needs some armor, but he's still not getting it. He's just getting more anti-tank, and I definitely think DevM might have gotten a bit stuck in a rut right there. Anti-tank gun moving up, riflemen lining up, though not the best conditioned men. Sniper as well. Oops by DevM, not entirely sure what that was about. Although, oh well. German assault going in, mine goes off, Volksgrenade is stopped, 30 caliber blast away, grenade off the Knight's Cross, killing, ooh, one man, another man down, so MG fire, ooh, mortar round a bit too close, and there we go, the assault is on. Panzer Force rolling into town. Anti-tank gun could go down any second if the Volksgrenade manage to get it knocked out by the 30 caliber. Is taking a heavy toll on them. And there we go. Volksgrenade are pushed away. The Panzer Force though still standing, blasting away. Ostwind moved away from the north. Infantry overall there gone. Another Panzer Force moves in. Raffin holding on barely by a thread. Assault into the town, air stalling bit, sticky bomb on the Panzer IV bits. But it managed nonetheless to actually damage the engine, which is a huge boon right there for DevM. But again, he's lacking the forces in town. Panzer IVs are heavily damaged. Volksgrenade right here getting gunned down in the middle of the street. Out in the open, down to one man. Oh, sniper gets him. Panzer IVs are heavily damaged. Mortar needs to get out of there. I repeat, and a sticky bomb from the rifleman again. Rifleman also needs to retreat. Just retreat everything you can from the town, DevM. Panzer IV is down. Panzer Kampfwagen Fierce and kaput. And a Königstiger has arrived in the meanwhile. Definitely leaving DevM in a bit of a problem. Second Panzer IV could be going down. One more hit. One more hit. This could be the end. Nope. And the 30 calibers also surprised. No, never mind. Gone. And there we go. Panzer Kampfwagen IV blown up. That's actually quite the death toll. And the sniper keeps on killing. Oh, the other unit might have lost there when he sent. Oops, might have been the sniper actually. And there we go, flanking about. Anti-tank gun crew and rifleman all exposed. Murdered and left for dead. But an anti-tank from the north knocked out the Osman. That's something. And the question becomes, how shall DevM get himself out of this? Sniper continues to be a nuisance behind enemy lines. Anti-tank and gone. King Tiger a bit exposed. Panzer IV fully repaired, moves up, 13 kills and 2 armor kills. That's probably more than likely to be anti-tank guns. Nice hit on the rifleman, the King Tiger takes its toll. More hits. And a firestorm goes off right against the anti-tank gun, threatening to cause a huge problem right there for DevM. Rifle charging ahead, doing what they can. Pioneers getting run off. Sticky bombs getting lobbed en masse on the Panzers. Damaged engine on the King Tiger. A nice swift assault. Might be a need to ignore the Panzer IV, just try and sticky bomb the King Tiger as much as possible. Get off some armor piercing rounds as well on the anti-tank gun. And there we go, he might in fact already have it. King Tiger almost down to half health. Rifle needs to retreat. Retreat, there we go, move the others in. Sticky bomb, sticky bomb. Off-map combat group, but definitely not providing DevM with what he wants. Instead, he gets an armor cast from Rangers and some other bits, including some rifle and what looks like to be an anti-tank gun. Not really the best off-map combat group. Veteran C3 Grenadiers quickly push in. Rifle moving up. Will there be Rangers supporting? Yes, indeed. And the Grenadiers leave while a new force advances, covered by the Panzer IV, Knights Cross and Volksgrenadiers charge in. Could easily make short work of those rifle, and there we go, getting gunned down. All the one squad gets suppressed. Rangers are moving up and in fact getting pinned. Desperate fighting for the town goes on. The Greyhound rolls in, helps with digging out the Knight's Cross from the church. Panzer IV getting repaired. Schnell, Helmut! My panzer must be shiny! And the King Tiger definitely in need of some repairs. Panzer IV, though, quickly getting skirts knocked off. Pieces of anything is knocked off by the anti-tank gun. Rangers won't be able to do so much again due to the armored skirts upgrade of Veteran C3. The main problem for the Panzer IV is essentially the anti-tank gun, and that does in the end force away the Panzer IV before the anti-tank gun crew gets it, leaving the Knight's Cross behind in the church. And barely any victory points left as another squad has snuck up here. Mortifier though goes in. Ooh. Down to one Ritterkreuzträger in the church. His assault rifle's firing at the rifleman outside, not quite having any success. Two Volksgrenadiers up north getting run off. The Grenadiers moving in to try and deal with it. And there we go, the Grenadiers arrive. Could we see a grenade? No, we could see them retreat instead. And right here would be a nice spot for a mortar round. I mean, that could really kill a lot of Pioneers. But the mortar's nowhere to be seen. Nor for that matter is any artillery.
This territory is Uncle Sam's. Just listen to that engine.
Armor car moving forwards, anti-tank and supporting. King Tiger sneaking out. Greyhound mine down, interesting enough, not a bad idea. And the King Tiger seems to be missing a bit. Perhaps not the most discreet movement of a cloaked pack, actually just knocking about everything else, thus giving a clear indicator of where they are. And some rifle here under heavy fire. Knights Cross firing over the fence. Managed to run at the point neutral, but that's about it. before the Ritterkreuzträger sent on their way. And the Panzer IV at the same time arrived with 17 kills to its name. Bit quiet though again. Again, the sort of strategy that DevM has gone for is a slightly less intense overall assault one. Slightly more methodical, but at the same time he is lacking armor, I think. If he just had some armor, he might have been doing a bit better, and I think he's rather trying and hoping that off-map combat group actually provides him with some tank destroyers, which sadly might not happen. Now, of course, it's the darker side of the off-map combat group. Sometimes you just get what you need, and sometimes you're just left a bit disappointed. There you go, they're pushing up. Mines being rushed into. Nice assault going on there by Lollipop and the Panzerlehr. Nice cross. Grenadiers. Volksgrenadiers. And the rifle just getting murdered.
Enemy unit down.
But the Volksgrenadiers hit another mine and they are completely evaporated while the armor car rolls in. Trying to deal with the Knight's Cross and does manage to land a nice position on them.
Infantry squad lost.
And a unit is actually lost for DevM. Not sure what it is. Another bust went out for Lollipop. Armor car quickly finding itself under fire, and there we go, off-map combat group. Two heavy machine guns arrive from squad and anti-tank gun, yes indeed. The absolute last thing he needed, pretty much. Heavy machine guns. And the propaganda war saves the victory point right there. The victory point drain continues against DevM and his men. We probably aren't very merry at this stage of the fight. We even see a bit of pressure being put upon the base of DevM with the Panzer IV moving in. Having snug in fact. Armored car actually somehow manages to halt the Ostwind, even sending it back. Incredible.
What are my coordinates?
Another anti-tank moving in there.
The Huns are taking our territory.
A rather tenuous situation for Lot DevM. And these are getting stopped by the 30 caliber. Anti-tank moving up, of course you could try and hold it that way, but he needs something to help sort of, you know, push out. He needs to deliver a certain undeniable blow to Lollipop and the Panzerlehr. Otherwise, he might not succeed quite as well as he'd hope.
Put us in the fight.
And another Ostwind. Lots of Ostwinds. Which did we not really see any fighting by the time of Normandy. They only came much, much later in the war. King Tiger moving about a bit. Could we finally see the beast rise from its slumber once more to be unleashed upon the Yankees? Hopefully. Let's just move this up a bit. And there we go, this could be it. Rifleman coming under intense fire from the King Tiger and the Knight's Cross. Rangers moving in, equipped with Thompsons. And another assault force lining up here. Lots of pioneers, my goodness. An awful lot of them, in fact. And two Ostwinds and a few grenadiers. And not really the strongest position. We are seeing some barbed wire here, but I think some tank traps might have worked a bit better, in fact. Rather interesting to consider. In fact, DevM has not bothered with a single tank trap, which could have worked, perhaps, you know, with all the armor he might have seen. Could have made it a lot more difficult for them to make any movement. And there we go, another firestorm going off. Oh my goodness! A rifleman squad and a ranger squad were killed by his own Greyhound mine, set off by Lollipop's firestorm. Oh dear. That is pretty much game over right there, if not anything. Greyhound right in front of everything. Steve, I'm on the King Tiger anti-tank and firing. Rifle squad down. 30 caliber in the church, not really of much use either. And the Panzer IV flanking from the other side of the river. How devious. And another Ostwind, heavily damaged. MG crew and the church are pretty much gone. There we go. Rifleman advancing, just getting blasted by the Ostwind, tearing through them one at a time, if not more. And that's just more Rifleman squads gone. And there we go, GG from both of them. A lollipop, not lollipop, that sounds a bit rude, but lollipop. That's why I have no idea what a lollipop would be. Begging, perhaps not. But yeah, perhaps not the strongest beginning. Lost a bit too much tempo early on. Another off map combat group, and finally he actually gets a tank destroyer. But that's simply too late. Greyhound booming in, facing off against the Panzer IV. Tiger getting repaired. Could be that the Panzer IV goes down, which would be a bit of a shame. There we go, Sticky Bomb. Although if one rifle gets crushed, Greyhound down, Panzer IV down. But that's about it. And the 30 caliber's watching the barbed wire, but not the flank right there. Oh, the Knight's Cross right out in front of it. And we are seeing an assault going in. And there we go, game over. Retreat for the 2nd Infantry Division, and they faltered under the armoured assault of the Panzerlehr. Interesting fight, certainly, but we rather saw that the problem for DevM was that he lost initiative, he lost sort of momentum as the fight sort of dragged on. The Jeep early on, the engineers early on, and then he went for the weapon support center. He probably shouldn't have gotten it there. He should have, you know, gone for something that helped him push a bit further, either some motor pool or some Browning automatics. Instead, he allowed him to slow himself further down, which made it much easier for Lollipop at that stage to actually contain him. I mean, all that barbed wire made it much more difficult for DevM to actually push forwards, and that, of course, rather worked to his advantage, that is, Lollipop's. Had he instead again gone for some armor curse early on, he might have been able to cause a bit more havoc, perhaps some Greyhound mines in a slightly more offensive manner. Sadly, that did not happen, and sadly, he never really managed to move beyond the motor pool. He should have gotten a tank depot, I think, at the very least as well after that. And sadly, the lack of armor ultimately, I think, rather, of course, gave Lollipop the full advantage in the longer run, as his Ostwinds and Panzer IV, despite losing them, of course, anti-tankers and such, were still able to sort of maneuver around better, and they were definitely much more difficult for his rifle and such to deal with. Even the anti-tankers had a bit, had to struggle a bit with the veteran C3 Panzer IVs, plus of course the Firestorm. So overall, pretty nicely played there by Lollipop. I think DevM could have recovered, you know, despite some of those nasty earlier things, but the lack of armor and perhaps the over-reliance on off-map combat group perhaps hurt him a bit too much. So there you go. Do hope you enjoyed this match. If you did, why not subscribe to your friends? And if you didn't, well, why not turn a replay of your own? This is Imperial Dane saying cheers.